And it was also a huge responsibility, because normally normally it's up to the artist to make a good artwork, and you just decide that it's good or not. And whereas now it was really, we had a lot of responsibility. And so I think one of the first things we did is quickly start thinking about how we can pass some of that responsibility on to people. So, and that was always the idea straight away, that the idea was, well, you'll be in charge of finding designers to develop the show. And so, I mean, that's something we're a little bit more comfortable with, having, curating a show and inviting artists to develop works for a show. So, I mean, that was something we were okay with. And so we quite quickly started thinking about who we could talk to and who we would want to work with. And then, Kazu decided that we would separate the two shows. So Jackie and I actually didn't talk about what each other was planning to do, and we talked to Kazu about it, but we thought, if we do talk together, we don't want it to be one big homogenous thing that sort of works together in a harmonious way, and we thought it would be much more exciting to have these two very different developments going along alongside each other, so that's what we decided to do. And I mean, Jackie, as you might know, if you've been up there, worked with a local designer, who's also an artist who developed a range of white garments, just designed a whole range of beautiful things from there just for one person. Whereas we worked with Sharon and Lisa to develop garments for two people. That was only one idea that was floating around initially, but that's what ended up. So I wonder if we could ask questions. Well, maybe I should talk a little bit more first about how I actually decided to work with Lisa and Sharon, both lecturers in AUT. So, because I'm actually doing my PhD and I'm in the university, it's a very comfortable sort of environment for me, although I'm at the university. But I thought, we initially thought that we would possibly work with students as well. But that was one idea that we ended up not running with. But that was kind of my initial thought. But, I mean, I work with students as well as a tutor in the university, and it was just something that I felt comfortable with and excited about the potential of students and also the teaching process and all of that. So that's how we initially decided to go to what I initially decided to go to and see what we got from there. So we got in touch, I got in touch with Lisa initially, and she was really just on board straight away. I think it was really exciting to talk to her about it. She seemed to get it right away, and so I was just wondering if you could talk a little bit about that, the start of it.
Initially, we talked about students and then the possibility that maybe either us are seeing students or something in collaboration. I thought, well, it sounds like a fantastic opportunity to open a wonderful thing to be part of. But even when we had the initial meeting, we met each other and talked about it. But just after that, we went back, talked about it, and thought, let us do it. And it's not something that we often get the opportunity. We're so busy doing our academic work and research and that sort of thing. So actually, to get back into what we do, because we've been practicing, so it's really lovely to get back and actually have a piece of time and have the patterns and draw the shapes. And so it was actually, I found that side of it, going back to that again, really good. So, I think we just sort of, was kind of sort of a nice decision to do it ourselves. And then,
We were really excited about that as well, because what we wanted to do, and this is something that I got from Kazu through his way of working, which is very much passing over responsibility and leaving a lot of freedom to make decisions and do things. And I thought that was a really important part of this work and how it was developing. So I wanted to bring that to Lisa and Sharon as well. And so that was really how that developed from there. And I think that what really excites me about this work is kind of this idea of, if you're one person making an artwork, you're in control of it completely, and it's very, very difficult to sort of extend out of your own way of thinking and your own sort of preconceived ideas and ways of doing things. Whereas if you're working with other people and you're actually passing responsibility over and allowing them to make something that they think is exciting, then you're actually expanding your own boundaries in the process. And that was one thing that I found. It's difficult to make that work because you can actually end up in a situation where it's sort of designed by committee where everyone's sort of going, oh, you know, it's going to be all right because everyone's going to do a part of it, you know, and then it ends up just being, you know, not that exciting. I think the only way that you can make that work is if you actually give people that responsibility and then they can run with it in a way that works for them and exciting for them. So that's important, I think, and that was what that meeting that we had initially was about. And then these guys went away and
I think what was good was you trying different suggestions of things. So I think it was your suggestion about the children and the mother and the Sharon's way and good ideas.
We felt like we had several ideas, and that was a bit frustrating because as designers normally, you know, you pitch a few ideas and the client says, yeah, I like that, we'll do that. But this time we pitched a few ideas and they went, yeah, whatever. You know, just do whatever you want to do. And so that was a little bit like, ooh, you know, again, quite a responsibility on us to what if we choose the wrong one with. But I do think that the idea of having garments whereby two people have to collaborate when they're in the garments, they have to negotiate how are they're actually going to move together and how they're going to, or otherwise they don't make it, you know, they fall over or they do it. So that's sort of, I think, tied back in quite a lot to the overarching sort of concept of just sort of passing on, you know, the everybody having to work together and having to sort of give up certain things that they would normally have control of. And that was quite an interesting thing.
I think the other thing for us, it was important that it didn't become we didn't want it to be the sort of classic wearable art where it looks like a boat or something, you know. And so the garments actually they're made of the box rewear, except that there's people that you could have. So, but they're really grounded in that they're clothing. So we work in fashion that features clothes for people, not a specific idea of art that just happens to be able to wear. So that is really important for us, that they have that integrity, that clothing integrity.
Kind of
have
some of the ideas behind it were about as I talked about, you know, your art being your life, or your kind of progress, it's an ongoing thing. So we had sort of three main kind of characters of a village or of a play, who would be, you know, people who get on with everything and get on well, who we represent as the dancers. And then there's the back-to-back people, the fighters, you know, the ones who are either fighting for that community or fighting each other, or, you know, the feisty ones. And then the other ones that are the kind of the they're together and they're, you know, the lovers that are kind of cuddly and embracing and they are going on outside and they, so there were those sort of three archetypal things that we did before.
So this process, while at the time we developed relationship with Lisa, Sharon and Andrea, is also an AUD design department joining at the first meeting. And I thought it was good. But at the time of maybe 3 months before, this headline, artistic director Nancy Thompson, she has a performance art background, and she asked me how I can actually make this plan happen at the actual site in headline. I didn't know what it means at first, but she asked me many questions and I realized audience, yeah, can easily be part of it. You have to have a bridge. So that was the time that I was with Amanda, and then Nancy brought podcast.